Good morning, everyone, and welcome to SMS News. I'm your host, Devin.
And I'm your co-host, Sydney.
Thank you for tuning into SMS News. We hope that everyone had a great weekend. Here's a look at our weather this week.
Softball had a great week last week with multiple big wins. Layla Cooper had a grand slam last Monday in the game against Cedar Creek. Way to go, ladies. We're excited about the rest of the season. The season will continue with games tonight, Tuesday and Thursday, Friday and Saturday. SMS will be holding a tournament at ULM. Please come out and support our Lady Panthers.
Our Winter Guard competed in Jennings last week, where they took first place. We'd like to take you to our reporter, Gabby, on location with Ms. McAllister. Gabby, what have you learned about Winter Guard?
I'm here with Ms. McAllister to learn about Winter Guard. If you don't know, we have a fantastic guard at SMS who came in first place at their meet last weekend. Ms. Mack, thank you for being here today.
Well, thank you for asking me.
So, what exactly is Winter Guard?
Well, Winter Guard is not much different from regular color guard, except obviously it's in the winter season. And we compete. We go to competitions and we get judged on our routine. It really originates from what they call WGI, which is Winter Guard International, a huge color guard organization that consists of mostly high school and colleges and independent guards across the nation.
How's Winter Guard different from color guard at football games?
Our routine that we prepare for Winter Guard basically tells a story. We have to have a theme. We also have to act out as well as perform the theme so the judges understand exactly what we're doing. And we're judged on a rubric, our dance, our how we handle our equipment. We just have to stay within all the criteria.
When and why did SMS choose to start Winter Guard?
A couple of years ago when my daughter Kaylee originally started color guard at the high school, I really just found a big interest when we went to Winter Guard competitions with her. The idea just grew, and the high school director and myself, we talked about it and how much it would help the high school guard if we developed a color guard here and the girls could just get so many more skills at an earlier level and earlier age. And by the time they get to the high school, it would just be much better.
What all goes into designing and preparing for a show?
Oh, a lot. Most of the things that go into designing a show, first thing we have to do is we have to select a particular type of music, and that music can't be too fast or too slow. The song that we choose needs to go with our theme or tell a story, main things, so we can build off of the song and all the movements that we do. Of course, we have to design the show. We have the choreography, all the different sets of equipment. Our flags have to match our routine. We have to build props that enhance our story. So it gives the overall view, and the judges can immediately see what we're trying to portray.
What are your goals for our program here at SMS?
Goals are to continue to build a bigger guard, get more members, and also to continue to raise the standard and raise the bar to where our students are constantly trying to get better. And when they go out to compete, that they really have a good chance of winning and showing out and sponsoring Sterlington Middle wonderfully.
Well, there you have it, to look exactly as Winter Guard. Thank you for taking the time to speak with us today, Ms. Mack. I'm Gabby King, and this is SMS News.
Thank you, Ms. McAllister. Thank you, Gabby. And congratulations again to our Winter Guard.
Here's what's happening at SMS. The Regional Social Studies Fair was last week at ULM. We had several students who participated. Max Brumfield, Devin Cooper, and Tyree Franklin placed third in the geographic category with their project titled Brazil. Bruin Foster and Hannon Mitchell placed fourth in the history category with their Babes of Baseball project. Cam Johnson, Ollie Powell, and Preston Reynolds placed fourth in the Louisiana history category with their project on the history of Mardi Gras. Way to go, guys. We're so proud of all of you. Ms. McCoy's science class performed an experiment last week that involved burning metal salts. Students, fire, what could go wrong? Let's take a look. Well, that was exciting. It certainly was. What's not exciting is the humanities leap test we're taking this week. 7th grade will test tomorrow, 8th grade on Wednesday, and 6th grade will test on Friday. Good luck, everyone. May the odds be ever in your favor.
The archery team will be selling strawberries and almond shortcakes. Everyone loves fresh strawberries. Each flat has 8 quarts of fresh strawberries and is only $25. The almond shortcakes sell for only $20.
If you're interested in buying a flat, please see any member of the archery team, Coach Focal, Miss Brandy, or Miss Pruitt. The money will be used to buy equipment for the team and help them pay for tournaments.
All orders and money are due on Wednesday, February 12th. Checks should be made payable to SMS Archery. These strawberries will be delivered to the school on the first week of March. Ms. Jessica Reynolds from Anytime Fitness was going to film a segment for us about nutrition. However, we didn't want to embarrass Preston, so she couldn't make it. Here's a word from some random person at Anytime Fitness.
Hi, my name is Pierre. I'm a fitness coach at Anytime Fitness. I encourage each of you to eat a healthy lunch. A healthy lunch does not include candy, chips, or soda. A healthy lunch includes fruits, vegetables, and protein. Food is fuel that gives you energy, which will help you be a better competitor in all athletics. Healthy lunch will also help build strength, muscle, endurance, and help you perform at a high level. Eat healthy, stay strong.
That's all for today. This has been SMS News.
Have a great day, Panthers!
Here we go. One more, Maddie. Hey, you got the bags.